As a wise man once said, everything dies. However, the sad truth is, when a species dies, they're done for good. Join us as we have a look at some of the animals on Earth that are dangerously close to extinction. The Northern White Rhino. Now, there may not be a better place to begin than with this animal here, the Northern White Rhino. But why do we say that? Well, for one, the creature is borderline extinct right now. Currently, there are only 2 northern white rhinos in the entire world, and what's worse is that both of these rhinos are female. The last known northern white rhino, whose name was Sudan, died on March 19th. Now, there is still a chance to save the species, as doctors were able to get genetic material, which could potentially impregnate the 2 remaining females. However, if it does work, the species has a long way to go before it ever gets off the endangered species list. But why is the creature nearly extinct? The simple answer is poachers. Poachers value the creature's horn and have killed virtually all of them for it. They've been protected for a while, but it's just not enough. And now that the last male is gone, things look grim for this particular rhino. The Sumatran Rhino. Sticking with the rhino family, you might be surprised to hear that some rhinos actually live in Asia, and one of them in particular is dangerously close to extinction. This one is called the Sumatran Rhino, and what makes it so special is that it's the only Asian rhino with 2 horns, which, to poachers, makes it even more rare and sought after. Now, unlike the northern white rhino, there are substantially more Sumatran rhinos, around 100 give or take. The catch here, though, is that while there are more rhinos that can breed, they honestly don't really breed that often. In fact, 2 females have been in captivity to try and save the species and have only given birth once in over 15 years. It also doesn't help that poachers are trying to take their horns because of the rarity, and thus, the less there are, the more valuable they become. Unless something changes quickly, they're likely on their way out of the world for good. Pika. Now, if you're like us, you've probably never even heard of pika until this moment. There's a good reason for that. It's because pika are native to China, and only in a very specific region, via the Xinjiang area. Now, as if that wasn't enough to keep them hidden, these creatures also like to live up in the high mountains and eat grass that grows in the highest of elevations. So as you can see, the little pika is truly one of a kind, but it also leads to its downfall in regards to the population numbers. Though there are no current definitive numbers, estimates state that the species is down to around 1,000. However, most experts believe that it's probably less than that. It's unclear how the pika will survive, but it'll be sad when they're gone because they're really kinda cute. The giant otter. When you think of an otter, you probably think of a small creature that roams around in the water. Now, what if those otters were 6 feet long? You'd probably find yourself looking at the giant otter. The giant otter only lives in South America, and these massive creatures have been around for quite a while, and it's honestly been part of the problem. Because of their size, they've been hunted down, mainly for their skins, by the natives. Fortunately, however, they've also been protected in a way that makes it illegal to hunt them, but that doesn't really stop their numbers from dwindling over the years. The waters in which they live are becoming more increasingly polluted, and because of that, their sources of food are also dwindling. And if you can't eat, you can't live. They're also hated by fishermen, which doesn't really help them at all. Finally, there's also a lot of gold mining that goes on in South America, and the expansion of it is hurting their habitats, including making mercury leak into the waters that they live in. If something isn't done to further protect the giant otter, they may soon be wiped out. The hawksbill turtle. Heading under the sea, life under the ocean isn't exempt from dying out as well, and in fact, you could actually argue that they're even more affected by man's creations than the land mammals. A good case of this argument is the hawksbill turtle. This creature's been around for a really long time, and it's actually a key part of the ecosystem of our oceans. You see, the turtle eats sponges, and these particular sponges are also harmful to coral reefs. So, the turtle is actually helping the reefs expand while also filling up its stomach, which isn't a bad trade-off if you think about it. But how is the turtle so close to extinction? Many species of the turtle find themselves caught and killed by fishing gear. Now, to be fair, they're not exactly being poached, they're just getting caught up in nets and lines that are meant for other creatures. And whether it's accidental or not, they're still dying out. As of now, the World Wildlife Federation has them listed as being critically endangered, and steps are being taken to try and protect the turtles. Whether it actually works or not, though, will remain to be seen. The Malayan Tiger. Now, you might think that only certain types of animals are hunted or poached. What's more, you may also believe that certain tops of the food chain are exempt from such things as being wiped out. But you'd be absolutely wrong. If you don't believe us, then look no further than the Malayan Tiger. This majestic creature is near the point of extinction, with estimates stating that there's only about 250 to 350 remaining. For a tiger species, that's not a whole lot at all. Ironically, they were originally thought to be part of a certain other subspecies of tiger, because they only live in Thailand, and only the most southern part of the country. Another fun fact, the species name for the Malayan tiger is Panthera tigris jacksoni, named after Peter Jackson, who has dedicated a lot of time and effort to protecting the tigers from poaching. If more isn't done soon to protect them, they may be wiped out. The Saola. The mysterious creature known as the Saola was only discovered in 1992. The finding of the creature was actually heralded as one of the greatest scientific finds in the last 50 years. But wait, there's more, and it's weird. The Saola are so mysterious that there's no real number that scientists can actually attach to their population. So, how do we know that they're near extinction? First off, the Saola is only found in the mountains of Vietnam and Laos. Secondly, due to its size and appearance, some believe that they're actually prey to other creatures, because they also look like cattle. And finally, it's also very rare to see one at all, because there are none of them in protective captivity. So if you do see one, you're seeing something special. But because of so many unknowns, it's very hard to protect the creature, which is why it's been on the critically endangered list since the exact moment that it was discovered. The Mountain Gorilla. Another example of larger creatures not being exempt from the threat of extinction is the mountain gorilla, which is actually a subspecies of another gorilla and lives specifically in the mountain range that borders the Congo, Rwanda, and Uganda. However, that's only half the story. Due to conservation efforts, nearly half of the remaining population of the mountain gorilla is kept in Uganda in a park for their protection. As for how these particular gorillas got to near extinction, it's a miracle that they aren't extinct already. Humanity's expansion in Africa has caused the gorillas to move higher into the mountains for safety. But unlike the pika, this move has caused many problems. This includes more dangerous conditions to try to survive in. They are equipped to handle the cold of the mountains via their thick fur, but it can't protect them from everything. Add those conditions to hunting and poaching, and it's easy to see why the numbers of this species are less than 1,000. However, unlike many on our list, conservation efforts have been helping, and there's hope that they'll be back into good numbers soon. It just goes to show you what protecting life can do. Vaquita. There's such a thing as a terrible title to have, and for the vaquita, it holds an unfortunate title of world's most rare marine animal. We say that because there's believed to be less than 60 of these porpoises left in the world, which makes it not only on the edge of extinction, but something that's very hard to help due to the low numbers. The vaquita are found in the Gulf of California and look like dolphins, but have some key differences. For example, they're only 5 feet long, making them the smallest porpoise on Earth. They also have patches of color scattered around their body in order to make them stand out, including some on their eyes and their mouths. Like many other animals on our list, the vaquita are victims of hunting, but in this case, it's by illegal fishing operations. Nets tangle up the vaquita and cause them to suffer and die. But there's also speculation that due to the rising temperatures of waters in the Gulf of California, that it's actually hurting them as well. Honestly, there's no way to truly tell. However, it is easy to see that the species is getting very close to dying out. There is some hope for the species, though, because the government is trying to protect these porpoises while they're still able to help them out. The white-rumped vulture. Ending with an eye in the sky, there are actually many different kinds of bird species that are near extinction. However, we mention the white-rumped vulture for a very specific purpose, mainly because the species has seen a 99% decrease in its population since the 1980s. Think about that for a moment. That means that in around 40 years, the population has been virtually wiped out. Even organizations that study populations and their decline note that it is truly catastrophic. It does, however, actually give the white-rumped vulture an honor of being the fastest declining bird species in history. Naturally, it's not really something that brings hope to those who are trying to save it. And as for what caused such a catastrophic decline, it all has to do with a veterinary drug called diclofenac. This drug is toxic to vultures, and three species are now nearing extinction because of the drug. What's more, the loss of these vulture species is having a major impact on the land of India, where they reside, showing that the ecosystem does have balance, and when it's thrown out of whack, everyone suffers. The giant squid. Release the Kraken. One of the scariest discoveries in the past decade has been that of the giant squid. Despite its rather unimpressive name, the giant squid is an awe-inspiring animal. Well, maybe terror-inducing animal. In 2006, Japanese fishermen began to report seeing freakishly large tentacles climbing up the sides